when Clueless hit theaters, fans probably would have had a hard time believing that Stacey Dash would become one of Hollywood's most controversial stars. Alas, today is not 1995, and in more recent years, Dash's viewpoints and outspoken nature seem to have taken the wheel. Here's how she ruined her career. The beginning of the end for Dash's public reputation was her affiliation with frequently criticized right-wing talking heads, like Piers Morgan and Sean Hannity. In 2012, she kicked off her career as a political commentator by appearing in a single episode of Piers Morgan Live. A cameo on Hannity followed shortly thereafter, and by 2014, the star was an official Fox News contributor. Unfortunately, her newfound TV success didn't last as long as her fervent support for Donald Trump. According to reports from Us Weekly, Dash was temporarily suspended from her position less than 2 years into her contract, following an outburst during an episode of Outnumbered in which she claimed that then-President Barack Obama didn't, quote, give a sh** about terrorism. Dash only managed to cling on for a few more months until her contract was up for renewal and the network gave her the axe. According to The Hollywood Reporter, this came in the fall of 2016, after numerous controversial rants on topics like transgender rights and immigration, as well as using the Pulse nightclub tragedy as a Donald Trump endorsement. This didn't go unnoticed by the Twitter sphere, which was so unsympathetic that her firing basically became a national holiday. One user wrote, "Dear Karma, good job on Dash," and that appeared to be the general consensus online. Dash is entitled to her own opinion, which is why her 2012 endorsement of Republican presidential candidate Mitt Romney only elicited some eye rolls and a few nasty Twitter comments. As The Washington Post points out, the star wasn't immune to racial backlash. But that backlash was nothing compared to what was on the horizon when she waged a war against BET, her Hollywood peers, and Viacom-CBS. The same company that supported some of her most prolific TV storylines. During a 2016 Fox & Friends rant, she said, "If we don't want segregation, then we need to get rid of channels like BET and the BET Awards and the Image Awards, where you are only awarded if you are black." According to The Washington Post, Dash's statements about the awards shows aren't even true. Though the BET Awards were created to predominantly celebrate black artists, who were largely ignored by other networks like MTV, the show still regularly nominates artists from various ethnicities. Justin Timberlake got 4 nominations in 2013 alone. Not to mention that, in the past, Dash has worked with BET, who promptly asked for their check back and published a gallery called Every Time Dash Proved She Was Clueless. Throughout Leonardo DiCaprio's massive film career, he's achieved several major nominations while remaining a vocal advocate for the planet's ongoing environmental issues. He serves on the board of numerous environmental protection organizations. When DiCaprio finally won an Oscar for his role in The Revenant in 2016, Dash threw him under the bus. In an essay on her website, Dash mocked DiCaprio's acceptance speech, where he spoke out about the threat of climate change, claiming that the actor's warnings were, quote, too much, and trying to disprove his comments. She wrote, "Leonardo DiCaprio, quit being Chicken Little. The sky is not falling." This did nothing to help align Dash with the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences, who've been looking to reduce their environmental impact year after year. According to Reuters, in 2020, they even banned plastic water bottles and chose a sustainably farmed menu, with a number of stars opting for eco-friendly looks. Meanwhile, Dash was busy on Twitter calling Al Gore ridiculous for his global warming film An Inconvenient Truth. In recent years, Hollywood has been working on its problem with LGBTQ+ visibility. As Them magazine notes, 2019 saw a record high number of gay, lesbian, and bi characters, but an unfortunate absence of trans characters. It's clear that there's still a lot of work to do, though people like Hunter Schafer, whose Euphoria role was critically acclaimed, or Elliot Page, who graced Time's cover in 2021 to discuss transgender rights, are helping pave the way. As Hollywood moves in a more inclusive direction, Dash has put herself in direct opposition. In 2016, the star released her memoir, There Goes My Social Life, From Clueless to Conservative, in which she ragged on Caitlyn Jenner for using the women's restroom. In an Entertainment Tonight interview discussing her book, she went as far as saying where she thinks transgender people should go to the bathroom.
Okay, then go to the bushes. I don't know what to tell you.
She claimed she was being made to suffer because transgender people, quote, can't decide what they want to be that day.
I'm not gonna put my child's life at risk because you want to change a law.
Needless to say, that didn't exactly align her with the so-called liberal agenda she claimed was being pushed by Hollywood, which is coincidentally responsible for her casting. Dash may not have done herself any favors when she aligned herself with a controversial film project that may very well go down as one of the most disastrous in history. As the Daily Beast reports, Roe v. Wade, which they called the, quote, craziest, most controversial movie of the year, was chaos from the very beginning. The anti-abortion film supposedly chronicles the 1973 Supreme Court decision that guaranteed a woman's right to an abortion with a pro-life tilt. But a leaked script revealed that the project reportedly pushed conspiracy theories and lies. According to The Hollywood Reporter, the movie was met with a casting nightmare as actors continuously ditched out after reading the script. Beyond that, the flick struggled to find financing, with critics regarding it as little more than anti-abortion propaganda. Dash stars as the founder of the National Right to Life Committee. She's even joined in the film by controversial right-wing pundit Tommy Lahren. Clearly, this is a film that has a very niche appeal, which is perhaps why it forewent the prestige of the film festival circuit, and according to Page Six, premiered at a Hyatt Regency in Orlando during the February 2021 Conservative Political Action Conference. At every turn, Dash seems to criticize her peers rather than stand by them, which certainly doesn't help her reputation in the industry. This was more than apparent when, in the same year that she started a war with BET and Black History Month, she likened Grey's Anatomy star Jesse Williams to a, quote, plantation slave, accusing the Black Lives Matter activist of being racist towards white people, referencing the actor's now-viral 2016 BET Humanitarian Award acceptance speech. She wrote in a scathing blog post, "You've just seen the perfect example of a Hollywood plantation slave, but the fact that you were standing on that stage at those awards tells people you really don't know what you're talking about, just spewing hate and anger." Williams has long been an outspoken human rights activist and produced the 2016 documentary Stay Woke, The Black Lives Matter Movement. His impassioned acceptance speech condemned systemic racism and police brutality, urging viewers to mobilize for change. As Hollywood was just months away from the bombshell Harvey Weinstein scandal and the launch of the Time's Up movement, Dash had a take on feminism that angered all genders across the board. In the same Entertainment Tonight interview where the former Clueless actress suggested that transgender people should urinate in bushes, she claimed that feminism had, quote, emasculated men. She said, "We are the most powerful creatures on the planet, women. That's why I hate when they say, 'I don't get this, I don't get that.' I'm like, come on, we have the men, we raise the men. So let's start letting them be men. Stop trying to be men. Let's be women. And let's let men be men. Let's empower them to be men because I feel like they're falling away." She also vaguely accused feminists of trying to take men's jobs, claiming she didn't have to, quote, try to beat a man or try and get a man's job to be a feminist. You either love Sharknado or you hate Sharknado. Either way, Dash may have learned something from the fourth and worst performing installment of the series, in which she starred as a mayor, only to get crushed by a house. If anything, she learned when to concede. This served her well during her 2018 congressional run. Fresh off the heels of a Fox News firing, Dash hit pause on her acting career and jumped into politics that February. According to CNN, she filed paperwork in California's 44th district, an overwhelmingly Democratic district, where it looked like she had almost no chance of winning. For reference, about 83% of people in that district voted for Hillary Clinton in 2016. Dash had already established herself as a fervent Donald Trump supporter and rabid conservative. About a month later, Dash withdrew from the running, claiming, "The overall bitterness surrounding our political process, participating in the rigors of campaigning, and holding elected office would be detrimental to the health and well-being of my family." If Dash took a step back in 2020, it may have been because she was navigating a tough divorce and the negative headlines that came in its wake. According to TMZ, her marital problems first emerged in September 2019 following a terrifying 911 call, in which she appeared to claim that her husband, Jeffrey Marty, had put her into a chokehold, which her manager refuted despite TMZ obtaining the audio. But in the end, Dash was ultimately arrested for alleged domestic battery because Marty had scratch marks. According to NBC News, the charges were dropped. For a while, it seemed like Dash and her fourth husband were soldiering on, but Dash filed for divorce in June 2020. According to TMZ, she put the day after her arrest as their date of separation. At this point, her acting career had already taken a hit. The star claimed that she was making just $2,500 a month in income. Weirdly enough, Marty, in a probable effort to speed things along or avoid paying spousal support, reportedly tried to get the marriage annulled by claiming he was essentially hypnotized into it. As TMZ reported, Marty claimed that Dash's pastor, quote, unexpectedly and suddenly proclaimed that it was God's will for him to marry the star, and that he used hypnotic prayer techniques, which hampered his ability to consent to the marriage. Dash reportedly wasn't against an annulment, though her attorney brushed off the claims of hypnotism. Since landing a spot on Fox News and positioning herself as a political pundit, Dash has racked up an army of bad PR over her outspoken nature. This has directly isolated her from her liberal peers in Hollywood, and as she claims, has cost her roles. In 2018, during her short-lived congressional run, the actor told The Guardian that her auditions were few and far between, and that politics were solely to blame. She said, "You're tolerated only if you fit their liberal profile. I've been blacklisted. I don't even get auditions." Nonetheless, the star is looking for redemption, and it seems like Hollywood may slowly be warming up to it. Following the Capitol riots in January 2021, Dash abandoned her support for then-President Donald Trump, telling the Daily Mail she was, quote, done, and even apologizing for her past behavior. She said, "I've lived my life being angry, which is what I was on Fox News. I was the angry, conservative black woman. And at that time in my life, it was who I was. I realized in 2016 that anger is unsustainable and it will destroy you. I don't want to be judged, so how dare I judge anyone else? So if anyone has ever felt that way about me, like I've judged, that I apologize for, because that's not who I am."
What people don't know is that I made a lot of mistakes. And because of that anger.
Dash has a handful of projects slated for 2021 and beyond, so the future may be looking bright after all. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Nicki Swift videos about your favorite celebs are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.